There are many institutions in a country which have a great impact and influence on the future of a country. One such institution, perhaps the most important and most effective institution of all these institutions, is the media. The media has a tremendous impact on the future of any country and can play a very effective role in shaping the future of that country. And in that context, this event aimed at media reform is, in my submission, a very valuable and timely event. Media reform is indeed a very comprehensive subject. It not merely will have to address the issues relating to how the media should function in a country, both in regard to normal matters and also more important matters pertaining to the governance of a country, pertaining to the future of a country, how they should function themselves in regard to these matters, how independent they should be, I do not think anyone would want their independence to be interfered with in any way. And all these aspects would have an impact on the media and would be perhaps issues that will be addressed in the course of an intensive study on media reform. We have had a checkered history in this country in regard to the media. We have had governments which have both implicitly and explicitly controlled and influenced the functioning of the media. There have also been instances when governments have been sent packing home when they tried to interfere with the media. I remember, I believe, in the mid-60s, there was an occasion when a government was defeated because the government attempted to interfere with the media. I happened to be present last morning at a media function in Jaffna, where a large number of citizens had gathered to pay tribute to 13 journalists of the Northern Peninsula who had been killed in recent times. We have many instances in this country where people have been assassinated for being fearless journalists. We also have instances in this country where people have disappeared for being independent journalists. We have instances in this country where assets of the media have been attacked. And it's a matter of great regret that in regard to none of these crimes which have been committed, anyone have been brought to book. Yesterday the question was raised in Jaffna as to why, even after the formation of a new government which is committed to good governance in this country, there has been no progress whatever made in regard to the investigation of those crimes that have been committed in respect of journalists. Wherever democracy has flourished and wherever democracy has thrived, there has been an independent media. An independent media, a fearless media, a courageous media is one of the pillars of democracy. and every journalist is a brick in that pillar. He contributes to the strength of that pillar. He contributes to the strength of that country. And that is something which I think every journalist should bear in mind. We are now moving into important times. We are trying to frame our country's supreme law. We are trying to frame our country's new constitution. This is a sacred duty. It's a duty in which all of us should take an interest. Up to now, this country has not had the benefit of a constitution which has been framed on the basis of consensus amongst all its people. The Prime Minister is here. The Prime Minister chairs a steering committee which will help frame this constitution on behalf of the Constitutional Assembly, comprising of the present Parliament. And I think it is a very important endeavour. The media has a very important role to play. The role of the media is going to be crucial. And I think the role of the media should be truthful, courageous, fearless, independent, and objective. We live in a pluralist country, inhabited by peoples who are multi-ethnic, multilingual, multicultural, and we need to frame a constitution that will cater to the demands of the society that we live in. This is an important role which will have a great impact on the future of this country. We are going to frame the country's supreme law, and that supreme law will have a great impact on the future of this country. That supreme law will determine whether the different peoples who constitute this country and who live in this country can be constituted into a single people, the Sri Lankan nation. That is the challenge before us. And that is a matter in regard to which I think the media should play a very impartial and objective role.